Hello, I'm Ethan Kenter from Dell Technologies. In this demo, I'll be showcasing a new feature in the PowerProtect Data Manager 19.10 release, Quick Recovery for Kubernetes. Quick Recovery enables restore of Kubernetes namespaces to an alternate cluster in a remote site. For that, a protection policy needs to be configured with replication to a remote PowerProtect DD in addition to primary protection. Metadata is being synced between the local PPDM and the remote one. Now, let's head over to the PowerProtect Data Manager UI to see all of that in action. First, let's look at the registered asset sources. We have our prod Kubernetes cluster register. We also have two PowerProtect DDs, one at the local site and the other one at the remote site. Now let's go to the protection policies view. There, as you can see, we have two protection policies. Let's zoom in to the MySQL policy. This policy has two stages. The first protects to the primary DD, and the second one replicates the data to the remote DD. Let's navigate to system settings and then disaster recovery to see the remote systems configuration where PPDM2 is configured as a remote system. This means that there is a metadata sync between the two PPDMs. Let's head over to the remote PowerProtect Data Manager. We'll quickly go over the configuration. We have a Kubernetes cluster at the remote site registered as an asset source. This will enable not only to protect namespaces running on that cluster, but also to restore data off the prod site to that cluster. The two PowerProtect DDs are registered on this PPDM as well. Now let's switch to the view of the local PowerProtect Data Manager through the remote PPDM. The assets view will show only assets that have replication stages in their policy. We'll go ahead and restore our MySQL namespace. We'll pick the latest copy. Select the Kubernetes cluster to restore to. We can restore specific PVCs with or without their namespaces. As we want our MySQL database to be operational on the remote site as soon as possible, we'll go with restore namespaces and PVCs. We also have the option of restoring to a new namespace or an existing one. We will go with the option of creating a new namespace and assign an original name to it, MySQL. We also have the option of changing the storage class to one that is compatible with the target cluster. Finally, we'll execute the restore. Great, the restore process was initiated. Let's monitor its progress. Awesome, the restore is now complete. Let's shift gears and open the console, the control plane node of the Kubernetes cluster running on the remote site. View the MySQL namespace that was created by the restore process. List its pod and connect to it. Now that we're in, let's check the data is indeed there by querying the database. As you can see, the data is there. We're all set. There you have it. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next demos.